Hello! Today I'm going to show you how to make a Victorian scrap album using directions from an 1883 magazine. You can use this album to hold and display dried flowers, cards, or pictures. Here's a list of all the supplies you will need for this project, which you can probably find around your own home. Step 1. Decide which direction you want your album to go. And take 4 sheets of your paper, and on the edge along where your spine will go, use a ruler to mark an even line 1 inch from your edge. Fold over the edge of your 4 sheets on the line, and turn 2 of your pages around, like so. Prepare the rest of your sheets in the same way, keeping each set of 4 sheets together. Step 2. Use a bodkin, awl, or needle to poke 6 holes down the middle of each set. Measure them to make sure they are in the same place on each set, and try to keep them evenly spaced. Step 3. Cut a strip of cotton 3 inches wide in the same height as your album pages. We will now sew our sets together. Cut and wax a length of thread, and starting from the outside, stitch in and out of your pre-made holes and through your cotton strip. Leave a tail of 3 to 4 inches where you started, and don't pull too tightly or you'll tear your paper. Once you reach the end of your first set, jump over to the next set, holding it in place with your hands as you work. Try not to jam them too closely together so that your album will be able to close all the way once you've pasted in your photos or flowers. Stitch each of your sets until all of them are attached, and once you reach the end, tie a knot with the tail you left at the beginning. Again, don't pull too tightly or you may tear your paper. Step 4. Now is the time for your cover. Our original directions ask for strong brown paper, but any decorative scrapbooking or cardstock type will do. Cut a piece large enough for your cover. It should be twice the size of your album, and don't forget to add extra for the width of your spine. Glue two pieces together if you need to. Next, cut a small piece of cardboard a little larger than the size of your spine. I used a piece from a small cardboard box. Glue this to the middle of the paper you cut out for your cover and let dry. Step 5. Stitch your cover to your album through the cotton strip on each side of your pages. Then stitch a wide ribbon over the spine to cover your stitches. Thank you. Step 6. Cut 2 more pieces of thick paper or cardboard the size of your cover and paste into the inside. I used some thin cardboard from a cheese cracker box. Stitch or glue ribbon around the outside edges of your cover. Then take the first and last pages of your album and glue to your covers to make a nice clean finish on the inside. Just put a little glue around the outside edges of your paper. Step 7. At this point, if you'd like, you can thread a ribbon through your cover for tying your album closed. Cut small slits the width of your ribbon in the back cover, and thread your ribbon through. Leave enough to be able to tie your album with a bow. Our directions recommend 2 ribbons, one at the top and one at the bottom. Lastly, decorate the cover of your new album. Our directions provide several options for decoration, such as printing scraps across the cover, trimming with garlands of dried flowers. Another option is to cut out a large picture, such as one from an old Valentine, and paste onto the front. Congrats! You've made your very first Victorian Scrap Album. This is a super versatile project and can be made from a whole variety of materials you probably have at home. Feel free to experiment with different colors and sizes of paper and different decorations. You can also do more or less pages depending on the size of the album you want. The article says you can also use things like envelopes or newspaper for your pages depending on what you have at hand. If you're wondering what you can put into your beautiful new album, here are some suggestions from the article and photographic examples of some real Victorian albums. You can do dried flowers, photographs, theming each page by season, doing cutouts from Christmas and birthday cards, putting in stories and poems, or anything else you want. I hope you had fun making albums with me. Comment below with what you want to add to your new album.